gospel of your Son, our Savior. And we pray that after his example, we may with ready wills and hearts obey the calling of our Lord to follow him. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you, Heavenly Father, for the witness of your apostle and evangelist Matthew to the gospel of your Son, our Savior. And we pray that, after his example, we may with ready wills and hearts obey the calling of the Lord to follow him through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
My child, do not forget my teaching, but let your heart keep my commandments, the lengths of days and years of life, and the abundant welfare they will give you. Do not let your loyalty and faithfulness forsake you. Bind them around your neck, write them on the tablet of your heart, so you will find favor and good repute in the sight of God and of people. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. And do not rely on your own insight. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make straight your paths. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand and join me in the reading of the Psalm 119, verses 33 through 40. Teach me, O Lord,
where are your statutes, and I shall keep it to the end. Give me understanding, and I shall keep your law. I shall keep it with all my heart. Make me open the path of your commandments, for that is my desire. Incline my heart to your decrees, and not to unjust gain. Turn my eyes from watching what is worthless. Give me life in your ways. Fulfill your promise to your servant, give training to those who fear you. Turn away the reproach which I have had, because your judgments are good. Behold, I long for your commandments, and your righteousness preserve my life.
Sacred writings that are able to instruct you for the salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All Scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for reproof, and for correction, and for training in righteousness so that everyone who belongs to God may be proficient, equipped for every good work. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hymn number 281.
Thank you.
was walking along, and he saw a man called Matthew sitting at the tax booth. And he said to him, "Follow me." And Matthew got up and followed him. And as Jesus sat at dinner in the house, many tax collectors and sinners came and were sitting with him and his disciples. When the Pharisees saw this, they said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" But when Jesus heard this, he said, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. Go and learn what this means. I desire mercy, not sacrifice. For I have come to call not the righteous, but sinners." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the living God, the Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, please be seated. As Jesus was walking along, he saw a man called Matthew sitting at the tax booth, and he said to him, "Follow me." Biblical art, sculpture and paintings that depict biblical themes, is something that I delight in because it enables you to bring another voice and another vision to the table. It enables you to do Bible study in the company of someone from another world, from another time, and certainly someone who sees things differently because they have the eyes of an artist. And that is why I have commended to your study this morning this painting, The Calling of St. Matthew, by the 16th century artist Caravaggio. If you go to Rome, you can see the original of this painting and in the church that it was commissioned for 400 years ago. And if you do, be prepared to be overwhelmed, as I was, because the original of this painting is 10.5 feet high and 11 feet wide. And I know it's murky. The original is murky. And that is appropriate because the world of Matthew, the sinner and tax collector, was a murky world. They extorted money from their own people. They were hated. And so what you see in this murky room, if you look on the left, you'll see Matthew and his associates at the table in the tax booth counting the extorted money. And then in the middle, you'll see a window. But notice that there is no light coming in from that window. And then over on the right, in the foreground, in the light robe, you see Peter. And then, almost out of sight, behind Peter is Christ. You can see his face. He is not very bright. He is not bathed in light. This is not a picture of the Transfiguration. The only little bit of light that he seems to emanate is this little sliver over his head that is halo, and that's how you know it's Christ. The light in this room is coming from behind Jesus. We can't see where the light is coming from, and that's because it's the light from God. Jesus brings the light with him. The light follows Jesus. This light from God that is illuminating this entire room. Imagine yourself for a moment in that murky, dark world. Imagine yourself in a place so dark that you can't even find a way out. How would that feel? Now, besides that new light that is coming in to startle you out of this darkness, the next thing you notice is a hand. The hand that is in the center with the red sleeve. That's the hand of Jesus pointing to Matthew. I want you all to try this. I want your hands to become this hand. So first of all, point. Point. Point at anybody. Now, feel how that feels. How does that feel as you are pointing at somebody? You're doing it wrong. You're ahead of me. Don't rush me. Now, raise your index finger and drop your wrist. How does that feel? Does that feel different from this? You notice it? You're already starting to get into this picture. And that's the hand of Jesus pointing to Matthew. Now, I'm going to tell you, there's something else about this hand. This position of the hand, you wouldn't know this, is the exact position of the finger of God touching, reaching out to touch Adam in the painting of the creation on the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel. And that's not by any mistake. So we see Jesus. He is pointing at Matthew. Matthew is the figure with the red beard. And you can now see his face and his hand. His face, his hand is and his face is like, who, me? Who, me? Imagine that. Now, make your face like that. Try to make your face like the face of me. I'm your sight. I'm not yourself as a person, perhaps, who just can't seem to do anything right. Maybe imagine yourself as someone with an addiction who can't seem to get out of it. Imagine someone who can't get over being angry, or someone who can't get over being judgmental, or someone who maybe doesn't pray enough. Imagine yourself as a person that seems to bring trouble. Or a person who maybe is hurting somebody repeatedly and can't seem to stop doing it. Imagine yourself as Matthew. And imagine yourself then seeing that light and saying, who? Me? And now, imagine Jesus saying, yes. Amen. Let us stand and reaffirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, the only begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of whom he is the Father. Through him all things are made, for us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified upon the cross, he suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, and in accordance with the Scriptures, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and see the kingdom of heaven have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and Son. With Father and Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead. And the life of the world to come. Amen.
Those for whom our prayers for healing and encouragement are asked today. Debbie, Joan, Elaine, Marilyn, Jack, Fetus, Carter, Harold, Lefty, John, Trudadan, Sophia, Chris, Sarah, David, Sherry, and Ellie. For all who face the fallout of alcohol, drug, or physical abuse, or love someone who does. For healing within ourselves and for those in our thoughts and hearts today. For all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble. For the peace and unity of the Church of God.
For all who are in the gospel and all who seek the truth.
For Michael, our presiding bishop. For Rob, our bishop, and for Trinity Church Meredith, where Bishop Hirschfield is visiting this morning, the Reverend Robin Thomas Solar, rector, and for all bishops and other ministers.
For all ministers.
For the special needs and concerns of this congregation, for the safe and speedy return of those deployed in the armed services, and for comfort for their families. For all who pray for peace worldwide, for assurance and blessing to those looking for work and for their families. Hear us, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life and remember those celebrating birthdays this week, Monica Wright, Brendan Batty, Kate Dayville, Alice McCurry, Brian Curry, Kelly Kennison, Lauren Tennant, Tony Howe, Deborah Moore, Samantha Murdoch, Rebecca Osborne, Katie Peterson, Janet Chamberlain, Matthew Erdahl, Eli Maswa, and Nancy Waller. And for those known to us celebrating anniversaries this week, including Peter and Sherry Maloney, Mark and Angela Batty, Steve and Rosemary Shaw, Edward and Heather Myers, Steve and Pat Hemmel, and Grant and Monica Wright. We will exalt you, O God, our King.
We praise your name forever and ever.
We pray for all who have died, remembering especially this week Brad Dow, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. And from our Book of Remembrance, we remember Terry Mazur, William Beal, Teresa Pepin. And the flowers on the altar this morning are given in loving memory of Riley Wolf. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them.
We
pray to you also for forgiveness.
Spirit, and we can live and serve you in the Jesus' name. Amen.
The Great Thanksgiving continues on page 367. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through the great shepherd of your flock, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who after his resurrection sent forth his apostles to preach the gospel and to teach all nations, and promised to be with them always, even to the end of the ages. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him, you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with Matthew and all your saints we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us eat the feast.
Turning to page 365, let us pray together. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Would Barbara Carboneau and Deb Haynes please come forward? Communion set. This one had a broken handle, and it looks like it's always hooked the spring through. Rainy, thank you so much. Barbara, bless you in your ministry. And Deb, Harold Chase, who's going to be you're going to be Harold Chase. Let's pray into the tips. Remember you will say this week. And Deb, thank you and bless you in your ministry. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Hymn number 530.
I was going to be serving communion.